We're now in a dry storage warehouse where the same type of sanitary design needs are in this room and just as important as the production space.
The first thing that we'd like to talk about is physical contaminants. So we can look at lighting. If you look at all of our lighting fixtures, they're self-contained. If a bulb were to break, then none of those bulb fragments would fall into any of our food product.
You also note that the packaging material and the food material is up on pallets. It's keeping it off the floor where it's easily cleanable. Also, they are, instead of against the wall, they're ideally 12 inches away, creating an inspectable corridor between them.
To keep our raw materials safe, we'll want to make sure that they're always enclosed. So any boxes that we have might be enclosed by taping them up at the end of our production day. If we have open bags, they would be kept in these rolling carts. Very important is that we physically separate our allergens and other sensitive products from non-allergen products.
It's just as important to protect the air supply coming into this room. The filtered air enters a central ductwork that runs the length of the room, but is located in the open alley space. That way, if any condensate or contaminants come from the ventilation, it falls in a safe area. Also, this room is under positive pressure ventilation, which prevents outside air from coming in, thus making sure that no contaminants come into this room.
And finally, our warehouse personnel always look at our packaging materials. They want to make sure that they're properly rotated so that when somebody takes something onto the production floor, it is the proper label.
So, protecting the dry storage warehouse, keeping the quality here translates into higher quality in the production floor.